Hey, I woke up at I think 10-ish tonight, which means I slept like 10 hours because I took my afternoon meds at 12:30 p.m. yesterday, and I didn't wake up until like 10:30 p.m. today. Okay, today's Wednesday. So I remember seeing Evan obviously in the morning on Tuesday, and then I don't remember anything. I don't remember seeing him again. So I slept from 12:30 Tuesday until 10:30 p.m. Tuesday when he was already in bed. You know, if he was a bad kid, he could be out having sex, taking drugs, doing all kinds of shit right now with my sleep schedule the way it is. Thank God he's not a bad kid. You know what I hate? I hate when I'm going to the bathroom, and so I put on a show like Wendy Williams or something so I can hear it when I'm in the bathroom, and then as soon as I get to the bathroom, we have an emergency action alert, an EAS system, an EAS alert, because that stops the program from playing, and I have to go back. When I can finally come downstairs, I have to go back and restart the show. Okay, I'm finally getting a little chilly. Oh my God, it says it's 75 degrees in here. Hold on, let me go try to find a jacket or something. Still be talking to you. I don't know how well you'll be able to hear me. There it is. There's my jacket that I'll put on. Excuse me, I forgot to talk to you. That damn boy that I gave birth to drinks his water. And I understand the reason for this, but still it irritates me. He drinks his water, does not crush the bottle, and does not throw the bottle in the trash. He just drops them on the floor. He doesn't crush them because that will wake me up in a pissed off mood, like, God damn it, don't you know I'm sleeping? Stop crushing the fucking bottles. But he could at least put them in the trash so I don't have to roll over them with my wheelchair. But does he do that? No. Because he enjoys, really, when I'm, and it's in the middle of the day or whatever, and I'm kind of sleeping, he enjoys crushing them just to scare me or wake me up. Okay, I'm tired of these colors, and I'm ready for them to be gone, but I don't know if you can see. My nail has only grown like a millimeter, but it's still really not. See how it's wearing off? It's really not wearing off that much for me to use acetone on my nails again. Because after I use acetone, I feel like I have to put Vaseline on it and wait a couple of days, you know, for them to, you know, heal or whatever. And then I can put some new fingernail polish on. Don't know if it helps, but that's what I do. And plus, I'll have to use a lot of acetone because this is one coat of that Sally Hansen Strong Nails, one coat of clear polish because the Strong Nails leaves like fibers on top of the nail in the fingernail polish, and then a coat of clear polish, two coats of regular polish, and then another coat of clear polish on top. So that's what, five coats? I'm gonna turn on this damn little heater down here. And you saw the way the compute, I mean, cam just tilted. It really did tilt that way, but to you, it looked like it tilted that way. That's whenever I move, the camera has the potential to move. Because I don't have a. Well, anyway, I've told you it's a flexible camera, so unless I really put it on there tight, then unless I really put it on there tight, then oh shit! Every time I get up out of bed, I forget to mess with my hair, so it ends up looking like I have a flat head, which I don't. But anyway, that picture when I was 19. See all that hair? That's mine. That was probably 1988. In other words, pre everybody had a weave. So yes, I can potentially grow my hair down to my bra strap, but I really can't take care of it anymore, so I don't. And since I've been sleeping from since 12:30, I really have nothing to tell you. Just wanted to let you know I'm still alive. That's all. Bye-bye.